Right now, we're going to kick it down to my girl, Becca Pruitt-Diddy, yeah. Our Nashville correspondent. Hey, she's interviewing my man, Urban D.
Overweight, a champ of Florida. I speak life until I meet the foreigner. I immigrated to this planet in the 70s. Cleverly. My life was played way back when in the heavenly habitation. No celebrities, just a lot of street cats that pretend to be something that they not, have something that they don't.
Becca here in Nashville, Tennessee. I get to talk to a guy that I think is so cool and did not want to stop talking to him. Urban D. He is a pastor out of Florida and been rapping for years and years, and he is awesome. Wait till you find out a little bit about Urban D up now. So I read a quote from you that said the message must stay the same, must not change, mm-hmm. but that the way you deliver it must constantly change to stay relevant. What's that about? Why do you think that's important?
Yeah, we got to constantly change because we live in a world that's constantly changing, and change isn't a bad thing. You know, music changes, style changes, all those type of things, neutral things. And so the way we present the message of God, you know, and his hope, we've got to continually evaluate that and say, how can we change it? And now with multimedia and, you know, all these cool things we have, we can present God's message in, you know, even a much more visual way, a better way. So where people can say, okay, I get that.
You're not only an artist, but you're a pastor at a church mm-hmm. in Florida, a hip-hop church.
Yep.
Break that down for me, hip-hop church. What's it all about?
Yeah, a lot of people think hip-hop church, that doesn't really sound like it goes together. And then also they'll think that every time we have church, it's just a big concert. Mm-hmm. And no, we're a real church. We do have real services, and there's worship. And there's, do you preach? Of course we preach, you know. Everything's just geared towards that culture. And that's really what I think the church as a whole needs to be trying to do more is, okay, how can we, you know, really make this message more relevant?
And every single carpenter from Columbus, Ohio, all the way to Tampa, Florida, I speak life until I meet the carpenter.
How do you reach those people? I mean, as a pastor and through your music, how do you reach them?
I think the biggest thing is to translate God's message in their terms so they can understand it. And I think, just like we talked about a few minutes ago, the presentation of God's word. And so many times it is very traditional. It is kind of judgmental or condemning. And the way we have our church set up, you know, it's very comfortable atmosphere. It's casual. The lights are dim. There's, you know, graffiti murals. It doesn't look like a church. Immediately you're like, wow, this is really cool. There's a music store in the lobby with listening stations and, you know, magazines. And they open up in prayer, and we don't use any big words or cliches. Then the turntables kick on and people are clapping and the lights are dim. There's smoke in the air and people are like, looking around like, wow, everybody looks like me.
Happiness, huh? It's all fits. I keep it original, I keep it simple, and in all of my gigs, I keep it Christ, yo. That's how this immigrant lives.
So immediately, a lot of their guards are down, and then as the service continues and as the message is brought, it's always brought in a way that they can apply it to their life. Go and say, okay, this is how I can apply God's word, and we say God's word is an instruction book. It's not a rule book, you know, but it's telling us how we can live our life better.
I want to go. It sounds so cool.
Come to
Florida. Tampa, Florida.
Now, like my man Peter said, if you're a believer in Christ, we're all just aliens, foreigners, strangers on this planet. Our true citizenship is in heaven. So if that's you,